But if you want to get educated, if you want to work hard, you want to acquire property, do charitable things, train yourself in music, art, whatever, this is the land to do it.
Amen.
Anybody disagree with me?
No.
Because I could call my friends and, you know, regard them all the insecure. No! That's why we have a wonderful blessing that we talked about. You can't do it in Iran. You can't do it in Syria. You can't do it in North Korea. You can't do it in Cuba. But you can do it here. So take advantage of what blessings God has given us in this great state of Maryland, in this great country of the United States, where we can worship God as we please, we can assemble together, we have no state religion forced upon us, not yet. And so while we have this time, I pray that God bless the people of the Hyattsville Church.
Amen.
You've been a faithful beacon, what, for some 80 years? And people are going to come and go and change. But the legacy and the lives that you touch, that is how you will be counted and weighed in the balance. I gave you the freedom, and I'm not talking about being judged for your works. I gave you the freedom, I gave you the talents. And maybe one more thing on this. In the story of the talents, the parable of talents, did everybody get the same amount of talents?
No.
Is that fair?
Yes
and no. Of course it's not fair. But everybody has a different gift and ability, and God's ways are not our ways. But everybody got a talent. Nobody was left out. The talents were different, but everybody got one. And the challenge to you is, God has given you some talent. Something. I'm sure of it. Maybe you haven't discovered it or developed it. And many of you have multiple talents. Use those talents to honor God and to lift up your fellow brother and sister.
Amen.
So Hyattsville family, may God bless you. We thank you for this opportunity to be here.
Amen.
And we ask God's blessings on your pastor, the first lady here. And may Hyattsville be a beacon until Jesus returns.
Amen. Amen.